Buddhist ascetics were not allowed to enter the crown villages. The punishment for the monks who entered the villages without permission was whipping by iron rods. If anyone motivated women to join Sangha, it resulted in severe punishment. Any man or woman suspected to have joined any ascetic order, including Buddhism, was caught by the police and punished severely. The monks were not allowed to organize sanghas in the villages. Not only this, the dwellings of the monks were to be established outside the royal cities and villages beyond the cremation grounds. But why did Chanakya recommend these kinds of oppressive measures against the Buddhist and other ascetic sects? In his famous masterpiece, Arthashastra, Chanakya mentions that the happiness of the king lies in the happiness of his subjects, and the welfare of the king depends on the welfare of his subjects. After this declaration, Chanakya proceeds with recommendations that are exactly the opposite to it, in a cold, grim, and materialistic approach. Chanakya is considered one of the greatest philosophers and economists that India ever produced. He is also famous with another name, Kautilya, which means crooked. He assisted Chandragupta Maurya in establishing one of the first empires of India and played a vital role in his rise to power. He authored Arthashastra, an ancient book written sometime in the 4th century BC. Arthashastra is a lengthy work of 5,348 verses in 150 chapters and meticulously analyzes the teachings of several sages. The Arthashastra is solely concerned with acquiring and preserving artha, which means wealth and power. Chanakya was concerned mainly with wealth and power, and nothing else interested him. There was no place of sentiment, fair play, and morality in pursuit of it. Consideration of dharma and welfare was secondary in Arthashastra. He had little interest in religion, except for using religion to promote the power of the king and the state. For him, the only use of holy men and ascetics was to employ them as spies. The Kautilyan state was totalitarian, which attempted to control every aspect of the life of its subject through its large bureaucracy. The state kept track of everything from birth and death to the movement of people. He also recommended keeping track of every aspect of the economy. He imposed a fine on throwing garbage on streets or road. There was heavy fine on urination near the road, temple, water body, or royal properties. Throwing out dead bodies or body parts of animals or human beings within city limits was also not permitted. There was even detailed traffic regulation. Though the traffic of the Mauryan cities consisted mostly of pedestrians and animal-driven carts, a cart moving without any driver or driven by a miner was not permitted. There were even rules against traffic accidents, though the traffic accidents were mostly in the form of collision with animal-driven carts. Protection of the environment was another major concern for Chanakya. Damaging trees led to a heavy fine, but the highest fine mentioned in Arthashastra was reserved for forcing a man into slavery. For Chanakya, forcing someone into slavery was one of the most serious crimes. Renouncing the life of a householder to become an ascetic without providing for the maintenance of his wife and children was not permitted. A person was allowed to become an ascetic only after attaining old age, that also only after receiving permission from a judge. He recommended severe punishment for anyone renouncing the world without fulfilling these conditions. Ascetic institutions which were opposed to his materialistic values were relegated to the periphery of the society. He believed that all undertakings of the king depended upon finance, and therefore the king should give maximum attention to the finances of the state. Agriculture was the mainstay of the modern economy, and Chanakya could not tolerate anything that disturbed the productivity of agriculture. The movement of people into villages was carefully monitored. Arthashastra shows that his attitude was very hostile towards ascetics. The great wave of renunciation, which was both cause and effect of ascetic streams, including Buddhism, threatened the integrity of the family and the varnashram system of Aryan society. Husbands were leaving wives, and wives were leaving husbands to join Sangha. This was disturbing the economic and social life of the villages and cities. Chanakya came up with some of the most extreme measures against asceticism. He discouraged imprisonment as a punishment measure. Instead, he believed in physical punishment and monetary fine. Buddhists and other ascetics were not permitted to enter crown villages. He feared that they will disturb the productivity of the farmers, and the monks may instigate disturbances in the villages. The movement of ascetics inside villages was heavily fined, and they were even whipped by iron rods for violating it. Sometimes, instead of fine, they were punished by forced fasting a few days. Fines were imposed on the host of the monks also. If anyone motivated women to join Sangha, it resulted in severe punishment. Any man or woman suspected to have joined any ascetic order, including Buddhism, was caught by the police and punished severely. The monks were not allowed to organize Sangha in the villages. Not only this, the dwellings of the monks were to be established outside the royal cities and villages beyond the cremation grounds. The Buddhist monks and other ascetics were not given any chance to come into contact with the people. He feared that this will disturb the economic activities of the people. However, Brahmin forest dwelling hermits, also called sannyasis, were allowed to move freely into the villages and royal cities. The economic and political system created by Chanakya was a very rigid one, where power and wealth were placed in the center stage and dharma and holy men were kept at the margins of the state affairs. Chanakya had a tragic end, and the political and economic system that he created also proved to be short-lived. When Ashoka became the emperor of India and embraced Buddhism, he reintroduced dharma into politics. He brought Buddhism into center stage, and ascetics and Sangha gained a prominent place in social life. The juggernaut of a cold materialistic system that Chanakya had built was destroyed by Ashoka, never to be assembled again. By the 6th century, the works of Chanakya were completely lost, only to be rediscovered during the early 20th century.